Now, turning the spotlight on Vicente Manansala, the life and works of the Philippine national artist are in focus in an exhibit by the multi-channel creative platform, Art House. To make the event more special, Art House is launching NFTs of rare, never-before-seen works by the master modernist. Now, for more on this, we are joined by Art House CEO Juan Carlos Pineda and ALAB featured artist Rona Manansala, who is also the granddaughter of Vicente Manansala. Good morning, you two. Thanks for joining us.
Hi. Hi, Nikki. Good morning. Thank you for having us.
Thanks for being on the show. So first off, this question is for you, Ms. Rona. So Art House pays homage to the live works of Philippine national artist Ed Cubist Pineda, your grandfather, Vicente Manansala. Tell us more about his works and where did this exhibit idea start?
Actually, the exhibit is actually focused on him. It's like introducing him to the younger generation. That's why Art House came up with the NFT version of his works. He's actually one of our first abstractionists here in the Philippines, one of the very first modern artists who did this. Of course, his inspiration came from maybe Picasso and so on, so who were known for the cubism style. He went to UP to take up his fine arts degree and then eventually taught in UST students there. This collaboration with Art House is like introducing the works of Vicente Manansala to the younger generation, reintroducing culture, and, you know, reminding them of where we came from.
Mm-hmm. And Sir Carlos, would you like to add any parang, how did this partnership come to be? Who approached you?
I actually approached Rona for this event. We really wanted to reintroduce our national artist, Vicente Manansala, to the younger generation. So Art House as a platform actually would like to create an opportunity for the younger generation to invest into art. So I think it's a good opportunity for us to tap a younger market. That's why we're also offering NFT at the same time, collaborating with very good senior and mid-career visual artists that are with us in the show today called ALAB.
Mm-hmm. And these are rare, never before seen works by the Philippine National Artists and Master Artists, right? So where were these kept beforehand? Why introduce them to the public now?
Actually, the collection are all private collections. Mm-hmm. So one is from the estate, Rona's family. And the other three, because we'll be showing four original Manansala rare pieces that have never been circulated in the market. Because after the artist created the pieces, they went straight to the private owners. And mm-hmm. since then, it's never been circulated. And Rona and I took the opportunity to share it with the market through an NFT. And because of that, it allows the market to potentially own a Manansala piece through this execution.
Mm-hmm. So, Ms. Rona, you still have the physical paintings.
Yes, I did. Mm-hmm. But I use physical painting, but on a different... How would you say? How would you call that, Carlo? I interpreted this unfinished. Yeah, I interpreted this unfinished artwork and did a mixed media version of that.
Yeah. So just to add to that, there's a piece of Mang Enteng that was unfinished. And we used that as an inspiration for Rona to create her final piece or her final interpretation of that same piece. Mm-hmm. But this time in her very unique way, which is cubistic and mixed media. So basically, that's what we're launching also, Rona's new series, mm-hmm. And new collection in this homage to her grandfather.
So yes, Ms. Rona is also a painter, following the footsteps of her great.
Yes, definitely.
All right. All right, so we'll get more onto that later on in the show. But why call the exhibit ALA? What will we be seeing there? What's the importance of holding such an event, regardless?
So basically what we want to do is ignite the viewer's imagination and emotion, because ALA literally means fire or flame. So that's the inspiration for the show. And we're hoping that, like what I said earlier, Art House is a multi-channel platform that would like to basically create a new market of investors, and at the same time be able to help younger artists that have challenges in looking for a market. Mm-hmm. So we basically will be the catalyst for this. And I think ALAB as a show, and working with Rona as the granddaughter and the estate of Manansala, would be a perfect opportunity to reintroduce that. And I guess making a show that the works of Manansala would stand time, right? From historic pieces of his cubism to future pieces in the NFT category.
And that, Ms. Rana, we know that other artists' work will also be showcased there, right? Each with their own distinct style and artistic vision. And most importantly, yours as well will be there. Can you tell us more about your art and their art? Will these all also be up for sale or auction?
Obviously, these artists are a lot younger than Vicente Manansala. So we would be like rendering different styles to, you know, like, how would you say, eterno sa generation now.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's...
Make it current.
Make it more modern.
And contemporary.
Exactly. Getting his theme, you know, adopting his theme and turning it into a more modern piece to, like I said, to introduce to this new generation of maybe future collectors. And everything now is, you know, being digitalized. So why not make art also, in you know, why not put art there also for, again, for the younger generation?
No, Sir Carlos, this one's free. Every exhibit, auction, show by Art House is specifically built to benefit causes that actually amplify conversations on environment, sustainability, nation building, to name a few. Can you expound on these causes?
Yes, Art House really is, its vision is to tell a tale about Philippine culture through the arts. So for us, it's very important. Every show we launch has a specific theme or communication that we want to address in the market. And for us, I think this is part of our way of nation building, because by doing that, we revitalize and, I guess, reposition the marketing of art and reintroducing it to a new generation, because the new generation today, they think a little bit differently from the traditional investors in art. And I think it's nice to kind of democratize that. I think there's a notion where art is very sophisticated and very expensive. You know? So with Art House, we want to break that barrier and create a bigger market. So their investments will reap benefit in the future.
Mm-hmm. And that, this Rana, as an artist, what's the future of the art scene here in the Philippines, as well as NFTs? Where do you see this going?
Me and Carlo were talking last night, talking about the future of NFT. Well, like I mentioned earlier, everything now is being digitalized. Well, future, we don't exactly, we can't say whether it's going to be there for a long time. Well, hopefully it will. But as it is now, well, NFT, I think, is being recognized, especially NFT in art is being recognized now by the younger generation. So, what the future holds for NFT, I can't say at the moment, really. Sorry.
For your part, Sir Carlos.
I think for me, NFT is a good opportunity. I guess we keep going back, no, to the younger generation, to the new generation. Basically, what it does, it allows a footprint in the blockchain. That's number one. Second, I think it fractionalizes pieces that are overly expensive, where I guess a regular newcomer getting into the art will not be able to, or will not yet be able to afford. And by doing that, they share a piece in that value, no?
Mm-hmm.
So by doing that, it allows us to give them that opportunity of investment. And by working with very solid names like our National Artist Sir Vicente Manansala, allows them to also piggyback on that brand recognition. So we, like what Rona said, we don't know yet where the future lies. We see that the potential is there. And we also know that there's a market readily available to take it on. Mm-hmm. So I think that that's where we're at right now.
All right. But lastly, before we let you go, when and where will this happen, this exhibit? Where can we see more details on this?
Okay. ALAB is an exhibit that will start today, 5 p.m., North Court of the Rockwell Power Plant Mall. That the exhibit will run until May 28th. And tomorrow at 5 p.m., May 26th, we will have the NFT auction at the Manansala, 38th floor Manansala building of Rockwell Center. So we really made sure that we would get the Manansala building to auction out the pieces.
Mm-hmm. Anything to add, Ms. Rana?
Oh, well, if you have time today and tomorrow, please, really, it would be an exciting show. I'm super looking forward to it. So please, anybody who has time, please do drop by the show. If not today, tomorrow, we'll be there till Sunday. So, yeah.
All right. On that note, thank you for gracing the show, Ms. Rona, Sir Carlos. You both stay safe and all good things ahead, all exciting things.
Thank you, Nikki. Thank you for having us. We appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you very much for having us.